Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. First, I would like to apologize for the delay between my videos. I will try my best to post at least twice a week or once a week. But today I'm coming back to show you how I make the glitter rolling trays and how I seal them. And to start off, we have a tray from Dollar Tree. You will need the jar, ashtray, and lighter. And this is what I use to seal it. And it is FDA approved. You'll need Mod Podge, glitter, and a brush. So first I start off by, I actually spray paint my tray when using the glitter, just so everything can be even and it won't be really see-through with the on the metal. So I went ahead and spray painted, and I am using rose gold glitter, so really when I spray paint, it'll bring out the glitter even more. So this is how we start. Gonna cover it in Mod Podge first. Okay, so we'll be spreading the Mod Podge. Once it's covered, I didn't do this bottom left corner yet because I'll do it after I pick it up to put the glitter on. So once it's covered, I'm gonna go ahead and start dumping the glitter on it. Like this. And I just pat the bottom to spread the glitter. That way I won't have to keep pouring it on at the container. And like I said, you do only need one layer, but it also depends on the glitter that you're using. Like sometimes the lighter colors and the bright colors require a second layer, especially like pink and teal. But since this is a dark color, you really don't need two layers. Okay, so this corner that I did not put Mod Podge on, I'm putting it on now. And I just dump more glitter. And then you'll notice some of the edges have Mod Podge and haven't really been covered completely. So I just take the end of my brush and do like this. And kind of just glide it along the glitter that I dumped off. So you want to make sure you touched all the edges. And if you have any questions, just comment below. This time I'll be sure to check my comment section because I missed it on my last video. I had to remember to check my comments. So this is how it looks once you've covered it in glitter. And again, this is rose gold that I'm using. And the words that I'll be putting on it, they're going to be teal. Okay, so what I'll do now, you can either let it sit overnight or for a few hours. It really doesn't take long to dry. You can probably, you know, just let it sit, especially if you put a thin layer. It doesn't take that long to dry. But what I'll do is put it in front of the fan, as usual, to speed up the process. Then I'll come back and show you all how I apply the epoxy. All right, the next step, once the glitter is completely dry, we take our part A and part B and pour it into two equal parts. So I take a clear cup. This is my part B. And I try to fill it to the first line. And a lot of people say it's really hard to use the epoxy, but as long as you use the correct measurements and spread it evenly and don't use the light once you pour it, then it'll dry completely overnight, really. So you just have to make sure you're pouring evenly. And those are both at the first line. And once I do that, go ahead and pour them together. It doesn't matter if you pour B into A or A into B, it'll still mix the same. You just take a little stick. You can use a popsicle stick. I believe this was a skewer and I just broke it in half. And you want to make sure that you scrape everything out of the cup so that it doesn't throw off your measurements. I usually just pour the cup over and let it sit. Just let everything drip out of it. So once you do that, you're going to stir it. Make sure you mix it properly. And if you stir it too fast, then it'll get a lot of bubbles in it. But you can remove the bubbles once you pour it, and get the bubbles out with the heat gun or a blow dryer. So once this is mixed well, we will pour it on the tray. And I've already glittered the lighter in the jar and ashtray. So that'll be our next step. Once it's all mixed well, I go ahead, pour it on the tray. Try not to put too much because I've experienced where I put too much epoxy on it and it never dried. So I just put a glove on and rub it around. I try to put a thin layer. Once this is dry tomorrow, that's when I'll add the words to go on the tray. And then once I add the words, I'm going to put another layer of epoxy on it so the words will be sealed in as well. Now this is how it looks once I evenly smoothed out all of the epoxy. And once it dries, it'll harden or it'll feel like a kind of like a plastic or glass surface. And what I do is turn on my space heater because it really won't dry well if you have it out, you know, in a low temperature. But with the space heater, it'll dry correctly. All right, so we'll be back tomorrow to add almost the finishing touches. And I'll show you how to apply the words as well. All right, guys, we are back the next day. This is how the tray looks after it is dry and hardened. So it really feels like, you know, plastic is now a hard surface. So I'm gonna show you how I weed out my words and apply them. And once you put the words on, then you're gonna put another layer of epoxy and it'll be ready the next day. So this is the design that we're adding to the tray. Just weeding out the words. Okay, and before I use my transfer tape, I'm going to cut off some of these pieces that I really can apply by hand. I'm just cutting these off because I won't have those between the design. Okay, so now I'm taking my transfer tape, carefully covering the design, and I kind of cut my tape too short once again. But that's okay. I'll just add the words for the last two letters of magnets by hand. I'm kind of placing, this tape is so sticky. Okay. Trying not to lay the design folded, but I'll go back in and correct whatever didn't lay right. again, once we add the design, we'll put another layer of epoxy to seal in the words. But now I'm just fixing whatever didn't lay correctly. But even if there are folds in some of the letters, once you add that top layer of epoxy, you won't even see any errors that you've made. And I kind of just rub my knife on top of it. Now I'm just adding the letters that didn't stick to my paper. That's how that'll look. And then we'll do the lighter ashtray and jar the same way. So this is how it looks once the design is complete. And I won't be showing you how I add the top layer, just to go ahead and get the video over with. But I will, on the last video, a lot of you asked, how do I make the multicolor rolling tray? And I'm gonna show you in just a second. This is how the set looks once completed. So of course I still have to add the top layer of epoxy to the tray as well as the ashtray. This is the jar. Lighter. And for the jar and the lighter, I actually used the triple thick instead of epoxy. You can still use epoxy, but I'm still learning how to prop things up to dry correctly with the epoxy. So I'll just be adding it to the tray as well as the ashtray, and it'll be up and ready to go tomorrow. But now I'll show you how I do the multicolor rolling tray. Okay, so now what I do, I just grab whatever colors I want to use for the tray. I'm gonna take a blue. So I just start from one corner to the next. Blue. And you can let each end dry if you want. But I just go ahead and spray them all together. And then I go over them a second time because some of the colors will bleed into each other. That's how you do the multicolor tray. Just let it dry. You can add another layer to even out the colors. And then you really can, you can seal it first or you can add the design. So that's how that looks. That's how you do the multicolor tray. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Tell a friend, share it to your social media. And we'll also put in the description box everything that we used in the video as well as our social media so you can check out more of our work. But thank you.